pleasant good morning to each and everyone, and welcome to this edition of the Titans of Democracy, right here on the street, 919 FM. Let me thank the Heavenly Father for bringing me here safe, sound, and all together in one piece. Pleasant good morning going on to my entire family. Good morning to the lovely Miss Sharon Felix, Mr. Daily Voice, and the entire families. Good morning to you, all our callers, all our listeners, all our viewers online. For those of you that are always locked on with us, it's always a pleasure to have you guys right here on the inside with us. Let me also say good morning going out to my friends and family in Tobago. Good morning. Hope everybody is locked on up and ready to go. Yeah. Auntie Pat Nats, morning. Plus good morning going out to the management and staff of the street 919 FM. Good morning to Mr. Iowa George and his entire family. So guys, at this time, you know, we open up the lines to take your morning greetings. So you can call me at 342-0081 and 466-5391. Those are my numbers. Yeah, give me a call. It's time to be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Yeah, time to get up. Call a good morning.
Bruce, good morning to you, my dearie.
Hi, morning. How you doing?
I could thank God for another day in the land of the living, and thank God for bringing you safe all through to Bruce.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
This is not easy right now, and especially this hour in the morning. You understand me?
Yeah.
I want to say good morning to Trinidad and Tobago. Everybody, good morning. Good morning, lovely host, and my friend, Mr. Leave It Right There. Good morning to you, my darling. Bruce, and call back. You have a good one.
You too. Take care. Caller, good morning.
Uncle Brucey, morning, man. How you do?
Hey, cool, Mr. Wong St. George. How you going?
I'm good.
Nice.
To hear you. Yes, right. Good to hear you. Right? Thank the Lord that you're safe and everything. Nice. Let me shout out. Mommy, you're first on the radio this morning on 91. Morning to you, Mommy. Mr. Manu. Mommy beat you and I beat you also. Get up, Mr. Mano. Wake up. Right. Fireman. Morning. Barataria. Morning. Sourman. Morning. Princess Tom. Morning. Oman Oga. Malcolm and Gemma. I must shout out Mr. Toronto. Morning. Leave it there. Morning. Mr. Archer, Crown Point, Georgie, Sister Crosby, Sister Dennis, morning to you all. Eve, Louise, Sister Gemma, morning. Mother Tanapuna, morning. Sister J, Anjay, morning. Right? So many girls, so many boys. Morning, boys and girls. Love you all, Adrian, Jabari, Isaiah, morning to you all my children and grandchildren, morning to you all, love you all, Prime Minister, morning, I saw you on the TV last night, get them, man, yes, right, morning to all the parliamentarians, right, especially the PNM parliamentarians, and cabinet ministers who they're working hard with Dr. Rowley to make Trinidad what we want for the future to come. Yes, morning, everybody. Wake up, Uncle Bruce is on the radio and waiting for whoever going to accompany him. Auntie Cheryl, morning, darling. I hope everything is okay with you. I hope we could hear you this morning. Right, happy Easter to you all also. Right, just in case I didn't get in Friday. So, right, morning. Love you all. I've gone with that Uncle Brucey. Yeah. Somebody must be on the line ready to call at it. Yeah.
342-0081-466-5391. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Bruce Wayne.
Morning.
Let me read it. It was on there. But we're still on. Right. Morning, Bruce Wayne.
Mm-hmm.
Good, you're right. Now, Brick. Well, First of all, I would say, you move like a Yankee, but you move to time. As I hear the gong, 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 it was at the 5 o'clock. Yeah, right. You move like a Yankee, but the time, right. But I would say, I believe in the house. He properly exercise, jealous no one, I repeat, jealous no one, and make a stranger happy or laugh. First, I would say morning to you and to your family. Morning to Sharon and her family. Morning to Iowa and his loving family for the this registration. And to Pastor Google and to Juju, yeah, and Mr. Aruka. And to all the 91.9 radio announcers. And to my friends in Tobago, the entertainers, well, I know now it's hard to to be with, but it's hard for me to come this year. But the entertainers stand, maybe Ivy, Samantha, Justice, and her husband, Selwyn, and to Mount St. George, you the king by Harvest, boy. And Mr. Archer, Miss Crosby, and to my friends in Trinidad, Fireman, Santa Gemma, Shack Shack Lady. Ah, Lady Mora, you're saying morning. I forget your girl, I don't got it. Happy, so I'll call you again. Lady Mora, see that? Malcolm, Olga, and to my friends in Balancier, and you will look at Death Man, I forgot you can laugh for your Lord. And my friends in Princess Song, the Retest Brothers, the Mark Brothers, and the Pastor Pin, and to Toxy Morning, right? And we're listening, morning, Toxie. Joy in Laramie, Hospital Joy. Elsa, long time I call you, Elsa. Marilyn and the party group, 15 members, Grazi, Duffs, Cheryl. Marilyn, Renelle and her mom, and my friend in Whiteland, Wendy, my lady, and the parent members, La Plenty. And to all my family calendars and to the all my friends in my village. Well, who's that thing that's it? And one love.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, later.
Caller, good morning.
A pleasant good morning to you, sir.
Hey, Chief, what's going on?
Everything good, man. I think you talk about everything, all right?
Yeah, man.
Everything good with you, right?
Yeah, man. Like, cool, man.
All right. Yeah, you and your family. And I say good morning to management staff, all the listeners, callers, yours, Texas, everything, please, to everybody. Mr. Malcolm and his wife, good morning. Morning to Princess Tong, Irie Village. Morning to Mount St. George's. Like you do it, yeah, always. Morning to Barataria. Morning to Sawa. Morning to everybody who does listen to them. Hey, Bruce, I have a new couple, a lily couple. I want to say good morning to them. They call them the OGs in movement. They listen to you all religiously.
Hmm.
So, I say good morning to them also.
Yeah, man.
And the people, love not the world. These are the things that are of the world. But if a man love the world, the love of God is not in him. But have a happy Holy Week. Blessings.
Caller, good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, morning.
Everything's good?
For the hour, man. What's going on with you?
Wonderful. I like the Baron, I said, holding on. My sister in Brooklyn says, good morning. Mommy, love, love, love. You know, I'm saying, yeah, boys are calling quick. Mount St. George. You hear Dr. Rowdy say he was reading a book last night. Attack from within. Bruce, remember that, eh? I'm going to tell you something one day. I will leave it here.
Mm-hmm. caller, good morning.
Morning, Brucey.
Hi, good morning, Jam Jam. How are you doing?
My name is Salive Die. Better live a ride. Morning, Mr. Monk St. George, Miss Crosby, my cousin Abby, my niece, Abbas Harry McKay and her husband. Also, good morning to the whole of Tobago. Plus, special good morning to my Prime Minister, his cabinet, and his family. Blessings to my cousin Walton and his wife, Miss Parsley Street. Blessing to them. Blessing to my friend Corinne, Erlen, and others. Okay. Blessing later, Brucey.
Yes, my dear. Three four two zero zero eight one four six six five three nine one. Caller, good morning.
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 If I can help somebody as I passed along. If I can help somebody with a word or song, if I can help somebody with a lasting word, then my living shall not be in vain. Thank you.
Three four two zero zero eight one four six six five three nine one. Where did my CG go? Caller, good morning.
Let's add love to you, Mr. Bruce Wayne, and your family this morning. Praise the Lord, you are here in Jesus' name.
Yes, yes.
To hear your voice again in Jesus' name. Let's add love to Mr. Voice and his family, also on Ms. Sharon Felix and her family, bringing in your safe in Jesus' name. Let's add love to my Titans family. Gemma, good morning, my dear Shak Shak lady, Mano. Mr. Chance, Barataria, Deep South, and all of the rest of the Titans, Oma Oga, blessed love to you all, Faizabad, Mr. Napuna, Angie, Mommy Sauce, Iva, all the rest of all my areas, Parsley Street, Mova, Beatum, Tumacac, Paradise Heights. Love, love, love. Keep the children safely in Jesus' name for the holidays, right? Tobago, Tobago, blessed love to you all, Mr. Monk St. George, Yvette and her sister in Tobago, and my in-laws, blessed love. Right? So each and everyone, take care of yourself. Jama morning, my dearie. If I can't remember if I did call you. Right? So love, love, love to each and everyone, Mr. Jason. Take care of yourself. Right? With love, love, love again, in Jesus' name. And I forget my Prime Minister and his family and his colleagues. Blessed love for you. Just keep holding on that balance wheel. Don't let go at all. And Miss Iowa George and his family. Love, love, love to you all. Strength. All goes to you. Always. Thank you, Mr. Jason.
Blessings.
Nice.
Thank you. guys. Call me up, call me up. It's time to be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, yeah. The morning is here, it's beautiful. Call it good morning.
Morning, Mr. Bruce Wayne.
Morning. How are you doing?
One of the listeners of 91.9. Morning. That's special morning to Mr. Manu. I hear this morning, Manu. This is Mr. Clarkson. Morning to you, Manu. Morning again. Bye-bye.
Yeah, man. Blessings. Caller, good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
You're picking me in trouble, you blind man in Katai.
Hey, morning. How you doing?
Hi, dear.
Oh, gosh, we had a link up.
Good morning to Success Lady. Good morning to Deep South. Good morning to Obad Oga. Good morning to each and everyone. I want to say a prayer for Sharon this morning. Mm-hmm. Father God, this morning, I bring Sharon before you, Lord. All the suffering with a cold heart, yes, Lord. I said, give her touch from the cover, soul of feet, and dry up the cold in the name of Jesus. So long, go Sakaki, Rabbi Sataraba. Touch you, Rabbi Hota, my God and my Redeemer. Touch you, Lord. Touch you from the cover of foot, and cover you with the blood of that. Cover you and his son and his husband for them, yes. Think about all to kind of man. Heal in the city this morning, oh God. Touch you, Lord Father, from the cover of the touch your stomach and heal that cold to always get in. I come against that cold, oh God. Touch you, the city this morning, Lord God. Have mercy, Lord, as I pray for you. See all you callers to touch his ears and listening and post and my calling and program, oh God. Let me have blessed over program. Touch each and every one this morning. Let me have blessed program. Cover the program, cover the Lord, to be blessed, good, and keep it in hand, Lord, for taking minutes going out and coming. All the announcers, keep them together, Lord. They'll bring you into love and peace and in righteousness in all the name, but in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Yeah, man, blessings. Thanks.
Paul Coleman.
Yeah.
And talk to me, right?
Nice. Okay. I will. Yeah.
Hello,
good morning.
Yes, Uncle Bruce, me again. You know, I never shout out this lady, Miss Patrick Street. Morning, darling. You always shout me, and I know you are related to Gemma somewhere, either sister in law, whatever. Morning to you, my darling. Thank you. Morning, honey. Love you. Maura, morning. All right, Professor Charles Dean Yates. Rowdy Junior, morning, man. Long time not give you a shout. Right? Love you all. Everybody leave it there. I hear the Prime Minister. I heard everything he said. And I like what he said. Because he know what he's all about. And he know what he's going to say and what he don't want to say. All right. I'm going to that on for this.
Yeah, man.
Good morning, Irie Village Princess Town. Also, good morning to Shack Shack Lady. That is, we was neighbor in Lavantel, Ebusi. Yes, her name is Mrs. Pravat. Yeah, morning, Shack Shack Lady. Blessings to you, my lady.
Thank you. caller, good morning.
Good morning, Bruce. Sorry about that.
Good morning, my dear. How are you this morning?
I'm fine, thanks. And how is my people?
They're doing very good.
All right. I want to wish you and members of your family, Ms. Sharon Felix, callers of the radio station, Mr. Monson George, etc., etc., a happy, happy, God bless Easter, and continue with your good works, and may God bless you and your family. Yes. Goodbye, Lucy.
Bye-bye.
And convey my regards and a happy Easter to members of your family.
Will do.
My people. Bye-bye.
Yes. So guys, at this time, I think we can get into our online papers for today, Tuesday, the 27th of March, 2024. Yeah. So let's get in on the inside and see what's taking place. So headlines in the Express this morning. 11 hurt in jail brawl. Inmates, officers clash after high-risk prisoner becomes violent. Focusing on Trini Beauty. And UNC loses election petition. So let's get in on the inside and see what's taking place in the Express here. So, driver killed in Trin City crash. One man was killed and a police officer injured in a road traffic accident yesterday morning in Trin City. The deceased was identified as Kevin Constantine of, of Grasshopper Lane in Digo Martin. Report said at around 1 a.m., Constantine was in a gray Mazda 323 proceeding east along the Churchill Roosevelt Highway when a vehicle came into contact with a blue Mitsubishi Lancer. At the time, the Lancer was attempting to maneuver north onto Trin City Central Road. Both vehicles sustained significant damage on impact. Constantine suffered fatal injuries. He died at the scene. Condolences to his family. By-election in Lengua. A local government by-election will have to take place in the Princess Tongue Regional Corporation to determine which political party will take control of the... will take control of the Lengua Indian Walk District. Yesterday afternoon, a three-judge panel at the appeal court in Port of Spain unanimously dismissed the appeal filed by the United National Congress, UNC, which contended that its candidate ought to have been declared the winner of the district following the last election in August 2023. SSA squad may have killed 10. Along with the assassination of a private contractor, Andy Daniel, law enforcement suspects at least 10 previous killings were carried out by an elite hit squad in the Strategic Services Agency, SSA. The Express understands that a significant part of a special branch report that Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley has received detailed the operations of the SSA's Special Operations Group, SOG, which has gone by other titles in the past, according to intelligence officials. Additionally, information regarding possible national security breaches was included in this report, which ultimately led to the SSA director, Major Roger Bess, being sent on administrative leave. Young, government closer to finding barges owners. The government is closer to finding the owners of the Gulfstream barge, which caused a massive oil spill when it sank off Cove Estate in Tobago last month. This from Energy Minister Stuart Young while speaking yesterday at the Magdalena Grand Resort at Lowlands during the launch of the public CNG station for Tobago. Brawl at City Jail. Police were called out to the Port of Spain prison yesterday morning after a disturbance was reported at the remand facility. The Express was told that around 10:15 a.m., a group of prisoners began acting in an aggravated manner when a high-risk prisoner who was being brought back to his cell confronted prison officers at the prison compound on Frederick Street. So these are the stories that are some of the stories that are making way in the Express at this time. So we're going to head over to the Newsday. Dr. Brown, water flowing in Maroon Diablo. JTOM rejects residential property tax. Independent senator. Government must listen to the people. Chief election officer. EBC to review operations as court suggests. Hines denies police unit reports to him. Prime Minister and businesses to partner on CCTV cameras. Brawl prompts prison reform calls. Let us hire our own. Brown, Commission of Inquiry Act reform this year. AG and opposition agree. Commission of Inquiry Act needs overhaul. Pet owner threatens to sue over teacup Maltese debt. Her place murder victim laid to rest. PM to meet diverse families today. TTMA head supports equitable residential property tax. Senate passes property tax bill. Court ruling means by-election in Princess Town Corporation. Two court red-handed in Point Fortin taking parts from stolen car. Family of man shot by policeman says friends caused his death. Autistic man shot dead. Family denies gang reports. Ashe visits Tobago. Shares spotlight with Miss Tobago, Renessa Ortiz. Port of Spain prison brawl leaves 11 injured. Family tied up, beaten, robbed in penal. Owned by Spanish-speaking men. So these are the stories that are making way in the Newsday. So we're going to head over to the Guardian. Headlines in The Guardian. Kamla lays down law. Kamla lays down UNC law, tells Parry. Dissidents to party line or face expulsion. Wow. Opposition leader Kamla Prasad Bisesa is threatening Mayaro MP Rushton Parry with expulsion from the party if he begins to vote against the party line in Parliament. In an exclusive interview with Guardian Media yesterday, Prasad Bisesa spoke frankly about the latest internal discord after Parry, on a public platform last Friday, issued a call for the United National Congress executive to respect the voice of its members and call the party's internal elections, which he said are due in June. Given the friction between Parry and Prasad Bisesa since the former's announcement, Guardian Media asks what their relationship would be like leading up to the next general election. What do you call this? Bacchanal in the city? Parry, I don't think I'll be victimized. Really? Appeal court rejects UNC's Lingua Indian Walk LG challenge by election to decide winner. Imbert, property tax will expose unjust enrichment. That is the Bacchanal Friday. Officers and inmates injured in prison skirmish. Hines claims he's unaware of any spy unit in TTPS. Woman arrested after being caught in video kicking child. Thank God. I don't know if any of y'all saw that video. I don't even want to see it. St. Joseph residents weighing on Griffith's plan to run for MP. Property tax pass in the upper house. Ashe makes waves in Tobago. Bipartisan support for Senate for COE reform. Farris questions central project that defies laws of physics. Woman wants $0.2 million after pet dog dies hours after vet visit. Gonzales, government to reveal decision on electricity rates soon. Ex-convict, shot dead in Arima. Digo Martin man dies after crashing into cop's car. Marval teen killed in Laventil. And these are the stories that are making way in The Guardian, The Express, and The Newsday at this time. So, as we normally do, excuse me, we invite you to go out there, get the papers of your choice, read up on the story, see what's happening. So, guys, I'm going to open back up the lines. You can call me at 342-0081 and 466-5391. Caller, good morning.
Yes, good morning to you, my brother.
Morning.
Morning to Sharon. Morning to Dubois. Morning to Pastor Google, Juju Love, and by extension, the Titans of Democracy. Morning to Sister Jenny, Sister Carol, Mommy Son, Shap Shap Lady, Miss Faisabad, Mr. Chance, our constituency group, Mr. Bartario, Rowdy Jr., Brian, Monkton John, Mr. Lover. Merry Christmas, brother, still in. Hope everything is all right with you, my brother. Boy, Mano, locked on as usual, King. Time for me to push back. There was never a good country. Boy, fireman, get up. Process on here. God with that thing, we have a godly day.
Yeah, man, blessings.
God is always the God's thing.
Caller, good morning.
Yes, Uncle Bruce. UNC will always have to lose. They are losers because they don't commit anything. All they do is try to object at everything. So they must lose again. Continue to lose UNC. And you hear who is the dictator? Dr. Rowley is a dictator. Dr. Rowley is a dictator. You see? You either do what I say or you will be fired or or push out, whatever. That is, you see, that is a dictator, not Dr. Rowley. I can't remember hearing Dr. Rowley talking like that. You understand? But this is the thing that's going on, right? And Mr. Imbert, or Finance Minister, that is a better way to salute you. Exactly what you said, even last night when you spoke it in Exodus Spaniard. That is what is going to happen, and that is what they are breaking for. Heard what the opposition leader said? She not own nothing in Trinidad and Tobago, or the world as a matter of fact. So, because she said, no way. So that is exactly what is the problem. They who own millions and billions and whatever, they don't want to pay nothing because they know people is finding, the government is finding them out, and we know all of them, what they get legal and illegal, and they don't want to pay for it, so they put in poor people. Poor people, me, I poor, and I ready to pay my property tax for my fatherland that is having Tobago. I was ready to pay because I know it as land and building taxes, $6, 3 shillings, as they used to say, and 3 shillings, Uncle Boosie, was a shilling was 24 cents in my young days, as a little boy in the early 50s. So I know about paying that. And my father and them, as the day reached for the taxes, they used to leave early January morning, maybe the second day of January, and go straight. Some people walk into Scarborough. Some people might get a little ride if they see somebody have a car and go and pay the taxes because they knew it was something good for them to own something in Trinidad and Tobago. So that is what it is all about. Pay up, people, poor people, you all pay all your taxes, please. Pay your property tax. It is something that is good. It is not draconian. You all pay your taxes and forget about all the people talking rubbish, especially the opposition people. They're just wasting all the time and talking rubbish.
Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Bruce. Are you with us again in the house here? Mm-hmm. Yeah? I would say, as I always do, eat properly, exercise, jealous no one, and make a stranger now. Well, Bruce, I went yesterday, and to find out about my payment, my tax, so next week I'm going to start to pay. I am proud to know I'll be signing the paper next week. That is one. And Bruce, two. Bruce, as Minister Ingold has said, this will show up all the plain clevers, millionaires, you know that, millionaires, you know that. Imagine Ansel Rosé. Suppose when will be the right time for this tax boy? Maybe 2065? Well, yeah, Bruce, have to be, because Bruce, no time is the right time in this country. But I want to say something. You could remember, Bruce, the late Marley McDonald, when she had some matter in the court, what Dr. Rowley had told her? Go and clear the court. Oh, Kamala and there had opened up. And, she had a matter in the court, and what she doing in Parliament? And Dr. Rowley said, Marlene, go and clear your name. Remember that, Bruce?
Yep.
Right. No, the great David Lee, and he has a matter in the court. The problem is this. I don't know why the parliamentarians don't do the same thing as they did and hung out Marlene. So why they don't let Kamala hung out David Lee? But no. He's the most boisterous man in the parliament that they tried to consume millions of dollars of his own expensive vehicle. Now, Bruce, I hope that Trinidadians ain't getting trapped because as it has been said, a lot of them, like me, have small tax to pay, but then they're querying for the billionaires, and then because you know, Bruce, those billionaires, they say nothing. use them out as scotch tape on it. But anyhow, I'll leave it there then. Yeah. Later.
Yeah, man. 3420081 4665391. Caller, good morning.
Lucy, it's me again.
Oi?
Yes, it's me again, darling. Bruce, I liked what the Prime Minister said last night, you know, and then they're going to be saying no to some people, you know, to understand the property tax. Mr. Ingber took his time and explained. You realize what they said, right? Those who have big houses, let's say I have a small house, you have a big house. Because the person who have the small house will pay the amount you have to pay. The big house only pay the same amount too. You understand it, right, Bruce?
Yeah.
Right. I'm glad how they explain it for people, you know, and they will continue to explain it for people. Bruce, we so happy in Trinidad and Tobago. As my cousin telling me yesterday, for a year in Boston, they have to pay tax about 3 times per year, no, Bruce? Yeah, and because if you think about it, it's small money, you know, Bruce. They're not telling you how to pay every month $1,000 on tax, you know. Mr. Ainbert explain it, and I want them to continue to explain it for people, you understand, to understand what has to be done. Bruce, let's be realistic. We have to pay tax, right? Am I wrong or right?
Yeah.
We have to, you know what I'm telling you about? Bruce, and I want to touch this election on Bungary. Thing yesterday is what the UNC lost the matter again.
Yeah.
So, you know, they have to go back to the poll, which will be a by-election, right? And the only person to be able to give it that date is the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago. You hear what I'm telling you about, Bruce? And you saw the opposition leader also, she challenged and she bringing out your rules. Bruce, I don't want you to go, you know. Trust me, I want you to stay right there, you know, Bruce, I have a reason why. Yeah, my darling. Have a good one.
Yeah, man. Take care. Caller, good morning.
Morning, brother.
Yeah, man.
Well, things start now, so you know about this tax. Apart from people who say they're living in a car to get a ACC house, you ever see anybody living in a car? How much is your insurance? You have a big fancy car. How much is your insurance every year? And you ain't want to pay a property tax, but all they have big SUV, 6 of them pack up in all the other, and they pay 3,000 and all kind of thing a year on insurance. Because you're driving a big car, so if you have a big house, spend big money. That is all I see it. All they're quarreling about. And Mr. Rose, they're paying you a salary, big to do nothing. Where's your contribution to what the people are representing? Go to court, strike. That's all you're thinking. There. And you're getting plenty of money for that. Pay your tax for the people, garbage and thing, pick up and all kind of thing.
Caller, good morning.
Bruce, morning, bro.
Hey, all good, my brother. How you seeing?
Hey, fine, thanks. Morning to everybody. Morning to all the titans. Morning to all the fighters out there. May God bless our nation. The underlying issue with this also, the property tax, is that the country literally have an anomaly of unity, where if all of us come together, we could actually, imagine you could literally say that property tax is a portion of diversification of the economy, where we contribute to the development of our individual areas, local government. This is part of the local government reform. Every time Mr. Patrick Manning or Dr. Rowley try to develop these areas, where these same bad mouthers coming and saying, oh, Dr. Rowley ain't getting nobody nothing.
There's nothing you gain me in them areas. I mean, very, very suffering. Imagine the property taxes once everybody agreed to it, literally trying to get these billionaires, and in some cases, sub-trillionaires, to contribute to the development of the society. The opposition rises up and prevents you, brother, in that area, Lavantil, Beetham, Mova, Marabella. They coming up to stop you from your development. Because when these property taxes are collected, all your brothers in all your areas, I work in that area right now with our real skilled brothers and things, everything will be concentrated in your particular area. The opposition do not want you, Mr. Shooter, Mr. User, excuse the boss head. They don't want Ole to develop in Ole area where Ole can come together as a community and make money dread. That property tax will focus on, concentrate on every individual area where it has sufferers. And the money could be used for the development of everybody in the area. And hear the thing about it. The councils and them will be controlling the finances, so it could even diversify into other areas, social aspects and social areas, and these rich people who steal people land, who play. It have people right now on the UNC side, know they get a land thief, know that the heirloom was stolen from them by some of the elite bandits that they have in their own community, but they cannot say nothing. And this fight for the property tax must be kept up. And I appreciate everybody, Mr. Bartel, Mr. Charles, Mr. Yates. I appreciate everybody who's keeping up this battle. They don't want black people to elevate. They want to keep you where you is so they can come and be your superhero and throw some crumbs to you. Doggy look a bone. That song that I'll be playing is for them. Them waiting on the bone, but this is pure and real development going to take place in this country. And the elites who could contribute to the development. That's why I like America, because they're serious about philanthropy. But we don't have philanthropists in this country. We have a set of people trying to keep black people down by not developing the area. And we need to, as Mr. Bartel said, only wake up. Only wake up, especially those who oppose it. Go look at the condition of all the areas. So all the areas will be developed, brothers will be getting work and jobs and be able to utilize the skills which is aplenty in Trinidad and Tobago in their own personal area. You ain't had a trip across the border, everybody could develop and a nice unity could take place in this country. They hate happiness. They are against happiness. They don't want nobody to be happy. Because they want to release the prisoners. I'll call back later. Locked on and listening.
Amen. Blessings. So guys, we're getting ready to go pay some bills. Keep it locked. We'll be right back. When we return, we're going to continue with your phone calls.
the season changes, let's continue to show that ocean of unity for each other. Let's harmonize that sweet rhythmic sound that comes from deep within, that reflects togetherness, getting back to the issues that matter the most. One mission, one station, the Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM. Mealtime rules. Don't serve yourself first. Do not eat with your mouth open. Don't make noise when eating. Does not apply when enjoying KFC buckets or our new Wii Deal. Get the Wii Deal for only $34.95.
Are you just tired of bad news in your communities, TV screens, and newspapers? Well, I have good news for you. Introducing Positive Corner with Naka every Tuesday from 12:30 p.m. to 1 p.m. Highlighting young, vibrant, and future stars, spreading our nation's banner across the world. Telling their story about their journey to success and overcoming the negativities that plagues our land. Come, let's sit, discuss, have a few laughs, but at the same time, learn something new. Every Tuesday, 12:30 p.m. to 1 p.m. Positive Corner, where challenges are opportunities for growth.
Turn your lights down low and listen to the Master's radio. Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
You are invited to join Pastor Morris Johnson of the Church of the Firstborn Assembly Miracle Center, located at number 399 Eastern Main Road, Waiko, in Sangre Grande, for the all-time gospel hour family radio ministry, every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. On Mondays, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., trauma and bereavement. Also, every Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., the low and you. Wednesdays from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., dealing with disabilities. And every Friday evening from 9 p.m. to 5 a.m., the all-night prayer live on the Street 919 FM, designed with you in mind. This program deals with the day's issues from a biblical perspective, and you'll also be given the opportunity to call in and interact with us. Micah 6:8 says, "He hath showed you, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of you, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God." Your financial support through the First Citizens Bank will be greatly appreciated. Account number 795-222. For further information, call 753-1113 or 610-4673.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
So welcome back. If you're just joining me, you're locked on to the Street 919 FM. This is your Titans of Democracy. The lines are open. You can call me at 342-0081 and 466-5391. Good morning.
Oui. Today is the day our Member of Parliament and Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago is supposed to meet the Paria family.
Yeah.
Bruce, are you aware that the DPP is still reviewing 380 pages?
Hmm. Okay.
So 380 pages, Bruce, is that a lot? You have to go through step by step by step, you understand me?
Yeah.
And beside that, it have other matters that we have to deal with also too, right, Bruce?
Yeah.
So it's a very tough one. But I feel, you know, please know that the Prime Minister is going to meet to them. But Bruce, I know, the best go the right road and not the wrong road. You hear what I'm telling you about, right?
Mm-hmm.
You hear what I'm telling you about? Because I know that gentleman go the right road and not the wrong road. You hear what I'm telling you about, Bruce?
Mm.
Have a good one.
You too. Take care. Caller, good morning.
You see, I got up my Prime Minister last night looking at the young and fresh as a rose boy. Like, more age is more young look.
Hmm. Caller, good morning.
Defender of Trinidad and Tobago. Good morning, sir.
Morning, my brother. How are you doing?
I'm alive. How are you this morning, sir?
I am doing great this morning.
God, thank God. We all are. But whatever ailments we have, and we're speaking to all who listen to us, we are alive. Once we wake up this morning, we're alive. So there's nothing greater than the gift of life to see another day.
True.
Fabric, calling the Manu, Sister Gemma, Manu, Pastor Street, male guru, female guru, Sister Jenny. Dominic, good morning. Mohaman, Sawaman, everybody, good morning. All the ladies, good morning. But I listened to the Prime Minister last night. Did you have a chance to have a look at him last night, Goosey?
Boy, actually, I was out cold.
Well, I know. Because I heard yesterday, yesterday morning, when they had a task from, I don't know when, so when you ask the man, you look. You sound like how I look, or you look like how I feel.
Yeah.
I realize I had a hard day probably the day before. But I after hearing my Prime Minister last night, if anybody in Trinidad and Tobago, so again, and this is the second time the man threw this statement, if all you have any allegations of corruption, all you know where to take it.
Hmm.
Right? So if all you know that my party is corrupted, that is the mantra all you're singing, point me to who? When or where, and let me deal with it. None of them apparently doesn't have that level of. But you know, as a young lady come on the platform last night, and after 20 something years, The Prime Minister admit, yeah, we're going to look like we get back nearly $1 billion or $2 billion from the airport scandal. I wonder how the supporters of the UNC feel this morning because they keep saying that it's a hoax and it ain't true. I wonder how they are feeling this morning. Bruce Wayne, enjoy your day.
Yeah.
After my Prime Minister, and kudos, according to the lady, and Manu, mash the gas and bend the corner and just keep steering. Who fall off, fall off. If you ain't strap on and put on your seatbelt, because it's a hard ride and a long one. After coming out of the pandemic, wow. So keep driving, and we hang on here. Mash the gas. We go balance the wheel in the back. You just mash the gas and keep carrying the nation forward, please. Good, thank you. Enjoy your day, my brother.
Yeah, man. Blessings. Caller, good morning.
Good morning to you, Bruce.
Hi, good morning, my dear. How are you this morning?
Oh, boy, I am good. You know, as the last caller said, we are in the land of the living. Yes. We have life. But while we sleep, we want to commend and salute our security services who look after us while we sleep at night and so on, you know?
Yes.
That we could have a safe country as much as possible. And I want to say good morning to all the callers and listeners and so on who are committed and dedicated to this station, right, to get all the information out. Brucey, my pet peeve is people making fuss about the property tax. All the low-income, middle-income earners and pensioners and all these people, you're paying about $80 a month or $90 a month, right?
Yeah.
The higher-end people will pay a little more. But when, imagine, Bruce, I know, when we want entertainment for cable and internet, Bruce, the average household, I understand, pays over $500 a month. Isn't that so?
Yep.
I went into that, to my cable provider. I said, listen to me. I can't take all, you know. You'll have to do something to bring this thing down, you know. Because that is a plane ticket to go on a vacation and to do other things. So we want a cable and an internet provider to bring the rate down to about 200, 250, 300. Not 500 and 600.
Hmm.
And then paying for Netflix using you have to pay US and all this kind of thing. Are you aware? That's what we have to fight for. It is too much for the average household, $500 and $600 a month. And when you take the property tax, which was land and building taxes, which is to provide garbage collection, all the other service goods and services we need in our communities to keep it going, and people want to make a fuss, we have to target those providers, cable and internet providers. It is too much. That is where our thing should go. Our focus should be on them, not on the property tax, which is to provide goods and services for every community. And also the young men in my community want to get jobs in the different corporations. So when they're able to collect more revenue, they'll be able to also provide jobs. So our thing is to be with those cable and internet providers. Thank you, my dear. We have to do something. Bring in a provider that could be reasonable. At least 300, not 500 and 600. Thank you, my dear.
Thank you. Caller, good morning.
Hey, Bruce.
Mm-hmm.
Last night, Dr. Rowley promised a gentleman he's going to work with them to put CCTV cameras throughout the island.
Mm-hmm.
And I am holding Dr. Rowley to that. Because back in the days, Dr. Rowley and Stuart Town do some nonsense pertaining to CCTV cameras. I will tell you about that one day, Bruce. But not today. I will leave it there for now.
Caller, good morning.
Brucey, my brother.
Hey. Uncle Malcolm, how are you doing?
Well, boy, I hear. Hanging in like Snoopy. Leave it there. Why don't you try to live a little longer, brother? Stop worrying about people, man. I doubt you'll reach my age if you ain't past it already. Anyhow, let me say morning to Maura. Mano, Mommy Sauce, 1285. Sharon, Ivy Village are inside. Mount St. George, Organ Homer, Mr. Napuna. Baratari, I hear you. Fireman, I ready to go and walk, brother. I'm going to walk with the wife this morning because on this day, 53 years ago, I got married, brother.
Happy anniversary, Bon.
Yeah. And, you know, I think a few men could have achieved this When I was a young, a small boy, I told my mother I want to marry somebody born the same day and month with her. And God gave me that privilege.
Nice.
Then I was born the same day, date, and month with my mother.
Hmm.
So, Gemma, happy anniversary, baby. I hope we live to see many more. Thank God, at this point in our life, the only pain we get is a little headache now and again because of the little sun sometimes. But other than that, all is well and good. Thank be to the Lord.
Nice, man.
Leave it there. Stop worrying, brother. Take it easy. Don't worry yourself about things that you can't change. You alone can't change the Trinidad and Tobago. So just calm down and let's live until we die, brother. So everybody, good morning. And I'm locked on and listening. So Brucey, Gemma, let's go, baby. We're going to take the walk now, brother.
Yeah, man. Blessings, man. And happy anniversary.
Thank you. Thank you, my brother. Have a good day.
You too, man. Take care. Caller, good morning. I lost it. Caller, good morning.
Morning.
Oui. Chief.
Zion. Bruce.
Oui.
Yeah. One thing I didn't forget is I want to tell my people, brother, don't let them use me like no buffalo soldiers again. Let them people go to front and fight the old war. Then we do like Ali Dan, strip me with title. Then people ain't do me nothing, I'm not going and fight for you. And people, if your parents tell you they can't give you something now, that they can't give it at all, are you going to kick your parents out of the house?
Hmm.
You had to wait. You will kick them out because they can't give it right away. Well, have a blessing.
Caller, good morning.
Yes, Uncle Bruce, me again. Mm-hmm. I just want to say something. That lady, I know her name, and I just forget it. The lady that called about the internet and whatever. Mm-hmm. There. Right? My darling, it's not that, no. We don't need these people to drop the internet bills and whatever, you know. They are giving us a service, but you know, everybody wants it. Every single person in Trinidad and Tobago want the people's service because we can't do it for ourselves. But they don't want to pay the property tax because it's Dr. Rowley and Colin Burt and this Burt and who Burt that bring property tax. But every person, don't care, even KFC and all, want the internet to come and talk on WhatsApp and talk rubbish. But we don't want to pay property tax where we live in. You understand? But we're paying for all the services where they come. A man buying a pack of cigarettes for $50 and all these sorts of things. But because Dr. Rowley is the prime minister, is he want property tax to bring burden upon poor people? Poor people might tail, and you have all the amenities that you have. I'm not saying that we're not supposed to have what we want to have. But everything is because of Dr. Rowley, and we're paying $400, $500, and $600 to watch foolishness on TV and all kind of thing every single day. So don't worry, let that stay like it is and leave it there. Let me tell you something. You can't hold Dr. Rowley to no word, you know. Dr. Rowley is a man to his word, and I told it, I said it yesterday. There's a man in Tobago that is called man to word. If he tell you he come in Saturday morning, he come in Saturday morning. And it's not Dr. Rowley putting up the cameras. He might employ somebody to whatever agent to do it and whatever, and they, because of their foolishness, do rubbish. So he would be thing, but Dr. Rowley is going to still let it happen. If he says so, he's going to do what he has to do as long as he has the time and it is possible for him to do it. So you don't have to hold him at his word. He is a man of his word. Understand? So this is the whole thing. People only pay all the property tax. Who don't want to pay it, let them argue in the court and whatever. And when they get the decision, they might have to pay twice the amount that they have to pay because they didn't pay for all the time. So they got to do all the arrears. So.
Caller, good morning.
Morning, Eddie.
Yeah, man.
I'll just say that from Tobago.
The Minister of Finance said to us last night, if your parents are unable to pay the property tax of the old person and they died and the property passes on to you, if you are not capable of paying the property tax, you would also fall in that very same bracket. But you know what was surprising? A young lady came on the platform last night and she started talking about a swimming pool. And you know, Prime Minister, why is they putting the swimming pool here and not there? So he said to her, you know, somebody write me a letter stating that they would like the swimming pool. And she said, I am the person. She said, he said, you are the person. She said, yes. So how would it happen, Maruga? Ting, ting, ting. He said, it's never going on. If it's you, then it's going to Maruga, you know, it's going to spot you want it. That is what he prime. So I don't know where they're living. And the man with the camera, hear what the Prime Minister said to us. You know, we find a body, a head. He said, because a head can't, the body can't walk away and leave the head. We find a head in town. But you know which part of the head was, had a camera? Right, which part of the head is have a camera? We paying $1,000 a month for the camera. But the camera can't show me no camera. So show me who rest down, who leave the head. So he telling the man, he said, so here what's going on? I hear about your initiative last week. But the man telling me, you ain't there for their cameras. It's not like how we seen cameras hanging all over the pole, right? Yes, in Tunapuna, their cameras. He said, are you watching you all now? He said, the police station, they set up a whole room in a police station in Tunapuna to look after the businessmen. So the Prime Minister said, your cost is way cheaper. That, imagine me paying $1,000 a month for a camera, Bruce Wayne. So how much cameras do you have on each pole? How much money that costs me? And the Prime Minister said to the man, well, yeah, what's going on? It seems that your own is way less cheaper than ours. So it looked like we want to find a way to partner with you to see if we could cut the cost and keep the thing more efficient.
Yeah.
Isn't that a brilliant, excellent idea? So I don't know where to leave it there and then I tell them, well, collect all your pension where all is in the coal and don't concern about what takes place here. Until all you come here to live, build a house, pay taxes. But they can make all your statements. But other than that, you deal with Biden and Trump. Perhaps one more thing that I don't know, Bruce Wayne, but I would leave it there. I will call back.
No problem. Caller, good morning.
Bruce.
Oi, morning.
It's me again. I want to touch on something. In the conversation last time with the Prime Minister, there was a gentleman from Sandy Grande, you know? He spoke fully well, and this young lady that the last caller now speak about there, and there was a young man from Love until Bruce. I was very proud to hear that, you know, what they achieve and what they continue to put out in the community. You hear what I'm telling you about Bruce? I was very, very nice of those two young people because, you know, regardless of what, young people must be recognized now. You hear me, Bruce?
Yeah.
You must recognize. Bruce, I don't know if I heard right last night when the Prime Minister said 64,000 firearms was it brought into this country, Bruce. 64,000? Bruce, I wonder if I was saying right. Of firearms brought in there, so that is why this one have a gun, that one have a gun. You realizing that, Bruce?
Yeah.
One person alone at 3 and 4. Bruce? I don't know what to say, but I am amazed. I was shocked to hear that amount of I am, Bruce. Have a good one.
Caller, good morning.
Hello, good morning, Bruce.
Good morning, my dear. How are you?
How you doing, darling?
I'm good. You're good?
Okay. All right. Boy, Mr. Malcolm. Sharon Felix, get well, darling. I'm talking to Papa God for you. Oh, God. You're a sick. Good morning, Mommy Salt, Angie, Esther. Morning, everybody. Morning, morning. Oh God, Omar, good morning. Billets, good morning. Bataria, good morning. And the man who they say eat properly and whatever. Good morning, my love. Love you all, Brucey.
Oui.
Good day, boy. Dale, you see you? You trouble, yes? Okay, Boosie, love you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Have a good one. Hello, good morning.
Yeah, very pleasant. Good morning to you, Mr. Bruce.
Morning.
Yeah, I watched the Prime Minister talk last night, and yeah, man, this Dr. Rowley is something special. We might realize it now, but I'm telling all you, this guy is something special. Because I watch how he converses with the people, very comfortable, not showing any signs of being fearful of answering questions like other so-called political aspirants who cannot face the media. But what stood out for me last night was a guy named Mr. Budu Singh, a businessman from Tunapuna, who told the Prime Minister about an initiative that was going on between the business association in Tunapuna, or one of the business associations in Tunapuna, and the police. And you see, it has been a tremendous success. And he put it to the Prime Minister that the government should try and get on board with this initiative. And for a time, I thought I might have been disappointed with Dr. Rowley for once. Eh? But you see, when he said the government will get on board with this initiative, I feel real good. I feel that's one of the greatest things I'm clear right so far. This initiative, If it go through your internet and thing, in Singapore right now, you don't have a crime. In Singapore, there is the bank and thing open. You know why? Because camera down. You cannot get away. So that is the initiative to bring into every police division in this country. I want to hear what the opposition and the naysayers and those who don't love this country have to say about this one. But the only thing with this one, I want the Prime Minister to remember, two things. The people them responsible, we have to keep the independence between the business side and the police very clear. But they have to vet, and everybody who go in there has to take a polygraph test. There is no time to play games. It's serious crime we're dealing with. So the initiative is a great one. Camera down the place and do the thing properly. Thank you very much, boss.
Yeah, man. Blessings. I intend to go back and take in that conversation with the Prime Minister yesterday and see what, you know, what was said and stuff like that. Caller, good morning.
Hey, Bruce. It's years I'm hearing Alexander on Beyond the Tape saying some of the CCTV cameras is not working in Port of Spain. So you put up CCTV cameras and nobody's servicing the CCTV cameras? What do you expect is going to happen? Not people going to put on heads in the road and the CCTV cameras ain't working? And nobody's servicing them? Barataria, come on now, man. Bruce, I will leave it here.
Caller, good morning.
Hello, good morning, Bruce. Leave it there. Oh God, leave me alone, boy. Leave us alone. Go away now. Go meet your sister now. Oh God, man. We fell up with you, boy. Rory don't want you. Dr. Rory don't want you, boy. He have a wife. Oh, shucks, man. Boy, Mr. Monk, St. John's, darling, don't forget you. Oh God, Jesus. Put a hand with these people. I don't like to go all the way, man. Bye. Love you, Boosie, again. Yes, I'm going. I'm calling again. Fair play, damn man. Oh, God, man.
Caller, good morning.
Morning, Mr. Bruce.
Yeah,
Mr.
Morning.
Bruce, you know, this is observation from the meeting last night. You know, you have to look at the different, now when you're hearing people criticizing the young people, look at the things that these young people are putting themselves through to study and all kinds of things. Because we have a few young people thing, we're going to play that all young people. I mean, that is enough. I'm thinking that means some people, when they're using that, they're speaking about their children, nieces, nephews, and, you know. And the initiative by the businessman, Mr. Bruce, that's a lauded one, and I laud the Prime Minister for connecting with it, you know. And also, Mr. Bruce, you know, when you're looking at this matter with Ms. Bisesan, all these people came from all these different areas to meet the Prime Minister and to speak with the Prime Minister. I wonder how it is that she is feeling when you're claiming that basically the nation and the people is so hungry and suffering, you know, Mr. Bruce. And then basically we're hearing all these initiatives around the world. I wonder how it is they just be feeling, you know, Mr. Bruce. But I guess maybe they don't have feelings, no conscience, Mr. Bruce. I locked on and listening.
Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Batman. You like hot cold, boy. Nobody sang up to you. When I say nobody, I mean me. You know, Laura calling.
True. Morning. How you doing, darling?
Yeah. Well, I'm good. I'm good. I'm getting dressed to conceal about my grandson.
Okay.
One is 9 months and one is 9 years. So you see what a good grandma I am at 75. Thank you, Father, for the strength, the health, the energy. And may God bless our country. Plenty, peace, love, and happiness. That's all I'm asking for now. I have to go now, honey. Have a nice day.
You too, darling. Take care. Nice to hear from you.
Take care. Bye.
What a beautiful Wednesday morning it is. The weather looks nice on the outside. Caller, good morning.
Yes, it is a beautiful Wednesday. And after hearing that lady Bushwin, I mean,
yeah.
Diamond, you know. You know what she tell us? She's 75. She's going and look after her grandchildren, and she feels proud to have the strength and the energy. So I hear somebody said to us, all of them were dead. Boy, you are a long, long, long wait. Because my God, without these people, I had no future. These people is what make the part that we could be saying long here today to have this conversation. Them 75 and 85, if you think our time is hard, them was worse than ours. Them is what build, them is the foundation that how we standing up here to raise we voice today. So kudos to all of you all. And thank you all for doing what you're doing. And please live long, because I want the next 5 years already to vote. Because there's a group of people who want to let it die, because they want the old people to go to get rid of what? The knowledge you already have, them can dream to acquire it. So thank you all very much for giving me what you all give us. Yeah. Enjoy your day, Bruce.
Yeah, man. Blessings. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Bruce.
Good morning, my dear. How are you this morning?
Oh, I'm good. How are you going?
I am doing fine, you know.
Beautiful Wednesday, right?
Yes.
It is a beautiful day today. Malcolm, good morning, you and Gemma. Happy anniversary. All God's blessings to you both. Long life and good health. And to the lady who says she's 75, Mama, good morning to you. Long life, good health. And may you live to see many, many more. Everybody, good morning. Manu, good morning. Sour Man, good morning. Parsley Street, good morning. Village, Deep South, good morning. Deep South, what's going on with you, boy? Mr. Mountain George in Tobago, everybody in Tobago. Leave it there, good morning. Mommy Sauce, Wrong Boss, good morning. Sharon Felix, good morning. Everybody, everybody, good morning. Everybody on the chat, good morning. Bruce, thank you for coming, brother. God bless you and keep you and give you the strength every morning. I know them hours to get up and to reach there on time. Oh gosh, I know. Know them hours, Bruce. Been there, done that. But God is good. Health and strength and all God's blessings to you on this holiday season. And stay safe, Bruce.
Thank you.
Everybody, good morning, and keep the children in check. Grandy, good morning. And to that lady who always laughing from Point, good morning to you, madam. Good morning. Bye, Bruce.
Bye-bye. Have a great one. Caller, good morning.
Bruce, good morning, bud.
Morning, morning.
How are you this morning?
Hi, day cool.
Morning to Trinidad and Tobago. Morning, Anne-Marie from CJUS. Bruce?
Oui?
I look at my prime minister last night. I put him in the same class with Biden. U.S. prime minister, president. And what caught my attention in the meeting last night? Dr. Rowley, you have a book in your head. You have a book in your head. And most importantly, you see the young lady with the swimming, who teaching them children to swim? My heart goes out to her. And Dr. Rowley, assist that young lady. She's making a very good contribution to her community. And the businessman from Tunapuna, I applaud you, brother. I applaud you all. And Bruce, we've seen there are sensible people in Trinidad and Tobago. Right? We still have hope for our little Twin Islands state. Though a real fellas like Lividia, you know, he must, when he call on the Muscotti off, let he call on the evening show from 4 to 7, that is where he deserves to go. That is his class. That is his school. Because he don't like them fellas. I don't know when the fellas in positivity, they want to bring negative vibration into this thing. I can't understand this man. Every time you come, you're objecting. What Dr. Rowley do? Dr. Rowley, your wife foul? Dr. Rowley, what? Take away your girlfriend or something like that? Or you went to him for something and you ain't get it? Lividia, get your act together and think like a big man. Right now, he's a big man. He's a little boy in big man clothes. Enjoy your rest of the day, Bruce.
Yeah, man. Take care. Good morning.
Hey, Bruce. Morning.
Hey, morning, morning.
Yeah, morning to Mary Lever, Fireman, Miss Cummins, Mommy Sauce, Theresa Conley. Hey, Bruce.
Oui?
I listened to the conversation last night with Dr. Rowley, right?
Mm-hmm.
And when Minister Imbert came, you hear the kind of money that the government had to look for every month? 4 point something billion dollars to pay salary, grants, and help the vulnerable. Eh? And people talking about right now the country being stable. So it's instabilize it with them misfits on the opposition and the robbers knocking at them. Them could sit down and do what this government here under Dr. Rowley is doing. Because, you know, we're having a regional ferry just now in the next 3 months going Guyana, Suriname, and St. Vincent, Trinidad. And Dr. Rowley is a transformational leader, people. That's the man to take Trinidad and Tobago forward. If he go for the next 5 years and somebody had to learn from him. Right now, the country is being stabilized. We cannot afford to put our next party there to destabilize our government and end up in the IMF. And our country will go in chaos, which probably had to cut public service jobs. They're telling you what to do. Get rid of this and get rid of that. He has stabilized our country. So people, that is the man we have to keep there, the PNM government. Okay? Bruce, thank you for this opportunity, man.
Yeah, man. Take care.
Okay.
Caller, good morning.
Oh, morning, Mr. Bruce again. Mr. Bruce, you know, I forgot to thank you for your yeoman service that you do to get up those hours of the morning to come here, to be here. And I also have to thank your callers because your caller seems to be up at the same time there waiting for you, like basically children and waiting on the parents who come home and bringing some goodies for them. So I have to say thank you and your callers and all your listeners and myself as a listener and a caller, Mr. Bruce, I have to thank you for your human service that you do to the radio station. So I said, let me call back and thank you for that. I didn't get to do that just now, so let me thank you. So I love doing and listening.
Yeah, man. Blessings. I appreciate that. Good morning.
It's a Gretchen again. Mm-hmm. Morning. Are you going to eat properly, exercise, jealousy, and make a stranger laugh? Now, Bruce, the woman, when I'm glad how I could speak about the 75-year-old,
mm-hmm.
She sounds so jolly, and a long time I've worked with her. She sounds so jolly at 75, Bruce. And she looked at me. Like, she doesn't have no high blood pressure or no sugar, so that is good. So it appears that she did what I have been saying for a long while. Eat properly, exercise, and always be jolly. Right, so I love her for that because, I mean, even though she's 75, I'll be 69 on the 3rd of December this year. Right, so I love to hear her. You know, she sounds, you know, overjoyed, overwhelmed. Right, and I love her. Okay,
Caller, good morning.
Yeah, morning again, Bruce. One more thing. Maintenance of these cameras, the process has been upgraded. The guy, if I heard right, within 24, 48 hours of any type of malfunction, there's a process to deal with that and get back things on board. So I heard someone talking about cameras not working. That long time thing. Remember, things upgrading every day.
Yeah.
And it has been upgraded to the point now that these things can be seen about in a more efficient way. We have to, according to our caller, we have to love where we live in. And we have to always do things to make things better. It's that time we have to put aside the politics, put aside the religion, and see one another as human beings living on the planet. Thank you very much.
Yeah, ma'am. Sometimes you just have to sit back, relax, take a deep breath, sip on your favorite drink if you even want to. Caller, good morning.
Good, Bruce.
Oui.
Boy, I tell you, this morning was a thing. Anyway, let me know, say nothing. Good morning to everybody. Morning, Miss Jean. Good morning, girlfriend. Hey, Mommy Sauce, good morning to you. It's already 5:05. Hey, Zina, time to get up. No PNN, go in, come in just now, you know, your son in your blanket. Yeah, man. Mr. Sowerman, good morning to you. Mr. Monk St. George, good morning. Mr. Clark Sunday, good morning. Yeah, 12:05. Mr. Clark, Mr. Faisabad, good morning. Malcolm and Jemma, woman over. Mr. Toronto. Yeah, man. Mr. Friday, good morning to you. Mr. Bonnie Gardens and Mongo. Mr. Napuna, good morning. Bataya, good morning. Yeah, man. And morning to everybody who ain't call. I ain't ready to forget, you know. But boys, I on since, you know, long. Who say how long you keep me on? Good. And then somebody call again. Me again, and I own the arsenal, but my money going on before I come to the communication, asking for some money to put on my phone. Anyway, good morning to everybody. Sharon, good morning to you. Yeah, man, voice, good morning. Yeah. Even Pastor Gugu, good morning to you. Nakia, good morning. I like you how you're moving up now. You're coming ahead of them, you know. You just know you're going to be number one in the station. Anyway, good morning to everybody. I people of Orange Gardens and Mount Hope. Just remember, give somebody something, say nothing about it. Go tell somebody that Bruce is on the air. Yeah, man, love is the answer. Look for the silver lining in the dark cloud. Our God.
Paula, good morning.
Good morning to you, Brucey, again.
Morning.
I want to thank you. I was so focused on these service providers. I'm so fed up for them. I have written letters to them and so on, but I forgot to thank you for your human service. As the gentleman said, you're coming out through thick and thin. Your work ethic is really superior. And I want to wish Taryn all the best. Get well soon. And also to gain the voice. You know? So I didn't know that you were there by your lonesome. You see? So we want to thank you for your service, boy. Thank you. You know, you remind me of a family living in the States who, where there's snow or whatever it is, they have to go out there with all their coats and everything and get the people job done. They can't stay home and call the boss and come in today, you know. Where there is snow, whether whatever condition, they have to find themselves on the job. But in Trinidad and Tobago, our work ethic among some people, I say all at all, among a few people, is poor. Very, very, very poor. And leaves much to be desired. Especially, I will say, the public service and so on. You know, their work ethic. So thank you, Bruce, for your work, your hard work. And to Sharon also, and Dale. And sorry that they're not there this morning. I really want Sharon to be on the up and up. And as the man said, she too, you too, I hope you're going to exercise too, Bruce. Do you?
Yes.
Excellent. Important. We have to strike a balance. Exercise, eat right. You know? So blessings to you, my dear. Talk to you later.
Bye-bye. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you.
Caller, good morning.
Hey, Brucey, morning. Morning.
Good morning, my dear. How are you?
How are you this morning?
I am fine. How are you doing?
Well, under my sheet still, listening to you. Leave it there. No, I don't want to make this program about Leave It There, but I had to call in this morning. I don't know if Leave It There suffering with some kind of mental sickness in the brain or something, you know. If I hire you to put up a camera for me in my business place and to maintain it, and the camera is not working, why I had to take the blame for it? That is why Dr. Rowley explained last night. That is why TSCT have the government in court, because they're asking for almost $1 billion that the government have for them for these CCTV cameras that the government refused to pay because the cameras and them were not working properly. Over half of the cameras and them in Tobago were not even working. Whatever pictures come up on the CCTV camera, they were blurry. Some of them are not seeing anything. That is why TSCT have the government in court now. And Dr. Rowley is right to, when he promised to go and partner with this man, because I watched, they had a part of it on the news at some night, and that thing is excellent. Excellent, I'm telling you. So I would be very glad when, not if, when Dr. Rowley and the government partner with these people, right? Leave it there. Like you have nothing to do. Like you just sleep, eat, and drink Dr. Rowley when the night come, when the day come. One finish, put on your makeup and go where you're going now. Bye-bye, Bruce. Have a blessed day.
You too. Take care. So guys, I'm going to go pay some bills. When we return, we're going to continue to our discussions, and I have a bit of information for you. So keep it locked to the Street 919 FM. I'll be right back.
the season changes, let's continue to show that ocean of unity for each other. Let's harmonize that sweet rhythmic sound that comes from deep within, that reflects togetherness, getting back to the issues that matter the most. One mission, one station, the Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM.
Greetings and blessing in the name of our wonderful Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm Valentine Garcia.
And I'm Nikki Garcia. And we would like to invite you to listen to the final hour broadcast every Monday from 12 midnight to 5 in the morning on the Street 919 FM radio.
Hear my mom, Pastor Helen Garcia, and myself, Pastor Valentine Garcia Jr., preach the word of God to the elderly, youth, and children. We can be contacted at 629-0113 or 623-8444.
Please be sure to tune in and prepare to be blessed.
Yes, my life I lay it on the altar. Yes, my life.
The presence of oxygen is absolutely the absence of disease. Most chronic diseases that plague us are not happening to us, but it's happening within us. We're literally eating ourselves to death, which means we're not living longer, we're dying longer. Join fitness expert Aloy Johnson, the founder of the Healthiest Corner on Earth, located at number 92 East Drive, Champlain, every Wednesday from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. live on the Street 919 FM, where he shows you that healing the body's temple is easier than anyone would have led you to believe.
You gotta catch this deal while it's here. Get hooked on KFC's fish for lunch this year. Curtis Catch tastes so good. You like it, yeah, I know you would. Delicious taste and great value. If it's fish you want, KFC's got it for you.
Drop your anchor at KFC this Lent and choose from delicious offers starting at $45. Catch them all at KFC.
Flow has gone cash back crazy. Woohoo! Get an instant $250 cash back on your bill when you sign up or upgrade to our Link Up plans. Or pay your bill on time and have your name entered for a chance to win $250 cash back. This is not a promotion. This is madness. Visit discoverflow.co today to sign up, upgrade, or pay your bill on time to get in on the cash back craziness. Flow, inspired by you.
The Gapman Limited specializes in products that cater to all your health needs. The Male Enhancement Package targets the areas of the body that contribute to erectile dysfunction. The Male Enhancement costs $1,400. The Gap Pills are priced at 250 pills for $500 and 500 pills for just $900. For the best in eye care, get the super combination of a Super Bright and the Body Healer. To improve the heart's function and circulation, get the Gap Pills and Formula C. To get a total body cleanse daily, use the Gap Body Healer and Big C, all for a super low price of $1,300. To order your products from the Gap Man Limited, call 628-4531 for products that cater to all your health needs.
For more info, contact 476-7268.
Spiritual Baptist Faith presents on Friday, 22nd March 2024, our first open air service at Isaac Junction, Coover at 7 p.m. Our dress code is national colors. Come and hear some dynamic men and women of God expound the gospel of Jesus Christ. On Monday, the 25th of March, 2024, the following activities will take place. Opening of the second entrepreneurial village at 6 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Men of Barlow service, 7:45 p.m. to 9 p.m. Dress code blue. Tuesday, the 26th of March, 2024, exhibition which commences from Tuesday to Thursday, 28th March, 2024, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Entrepreneurial Village, Tuesday to Saturday from 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. DOC Presentation, Tuesday to Thursday, 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Youth for Christ, dress code white, starts at 6 p.m. Wednesday, the 27th of March, 2024, Woman of Substance Service. The time is 6 p.m., dress code pink. Thursday, the 28th of March, 2024, Myla Spiritual Baptist Experience. Starts 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. The Spiritual Baptist Diaspora Service. Time is 6 p.m., dress colored. Saturday, the 30th of March, 2024, Spiritual Baptist Liberation Day Service, which commences at 9 a.m., dress code colored. All events will take place at the Administrative Building, Balmain, Cuba. See you there.
Everybody sipping up the juice. Everybody drinking up the juice. Everybody buying up the juice. When you drink, you get a natural boost. Zero sugar, calorie low. Same great taste on it, sweet for so. Boost up the energy when you want to go. 100% natural, what we know. In a new bottle with a new design. In the evolution, we are move with the times. Give me turmeric, ginger and lime. That's why they feeling fine. So they say, everybody sipping up the juice. Renew the power in you.
This is the voice of Tuzia, Seventh-day Adventist. We are preaching emergency alert broadcast, which is from the Tuzia Seventh-day Adventist Church. We will be featuring voices of brethren from different parts of the world, preaching the gospel, preaching prophecy as it relates to current events and the ending of the world. Listen to us on 91.9 FM every Sunday from 9.05 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Sundays. May God bless you as you learn the truth. In Jesus' name, amen.
Job Optimum Health and Wellness. Are you sick and tired of being sick and tired? Get your Bioplasma Diagnostic Full Body Scan. Examines all of your organs in a single session. 95% accuracy. It's painless, non-invasive, and affordable. Call Pastor Job at 350-2628, 767-1031, or 275-6300. Sick and tired of being sick and tired? Get your Bioplasma Diagnostic Full Body Scan at Job Optimum Health and Wellness.
Tune in to The Street 919 FM every Friday from 9:15 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. with Kingdom Health Services, situated at number 125 to 186 Eastern Main Road in Tuna, Puna. For the program, Health and Healing, Merging the Old with the New, with Mr. Brent Diet. For more information, call 318-7471 or 484-0141 or 360-4100. It's all about Kingdom Health Services on The Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of The Street 919 FM.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
back. Welcome back on the inside. You're locked on to the Street 919 FM. This is your Titans of Democracy, and I have just a bit of information for you. Natural Health Solutions Limited features educational platforms, medication segment every Tuesday at 8:05 a.m. to 8:35 a.m. right here on the Street 909 FM. Just call us at 222-2189 or WhatsApp only at 304-5816 in Trinidad or 732-9186 in Tobago. Our location is number 8 Ozonville Road, St. Augustine, and number 40 Wilson Road, Scarborough, Tobago. Business hours are 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday to Friday, 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Saturday. Why is this still in my folder? Spiritual Baptist Faith presents Wednesday, the 27th of March, that's today, 2024, Woman of Substance service, time 6 p.m., dress code pink. On Thursday, the 28th of March, 2024, part 1, Mile at Spiritual Baptist Experience, time 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., and part 2, the Spiritual Baptist Diaspora Service, time 6 p.m., dress code colored. On Saturday, the 30th of March, 2024, Spiritual Baptist Liberation Day Service, which commences at 9 a.m., dress code is colored. Remember, all events take place at the Administrative Building, Balmain, Coover. See you there. Yeah, gotta look out for that, eh? Tune into the Street 919 FM every second, third, and fourth Thursday at 8 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Welcome you to Reset with Dr. Livett, your weekly guide to holistic health and wellness, as we dive deep into the world of holistic health. From ancient herbal remedies to cutting-edge holistic practices, we'll explore it all. Join Dr. Livett with over 11 years of experience as a holistic health practitioner, healer, and master herbalist, as he shares invaluable insights to help you reset your mind, body, and spirit. Reset with Dr. Livett every second, third, and fourth Thursdays at 8 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. only on the Street 919 FM. Enjoy massive Easter savings at Furniture Plus today and get free gifts with select purchases in store and online. Shop mini appliances from $145, camping gear from $169, queen mattresses from $695, bed frames from $799, appliances from $1,499 and more. Plus, shop combo and BOGO deals galore. No cash. Pay $1 down on higher purchase plans. Conditions apply. All stores open Monday to Saturday. Shops of Rima store opens on Sunday from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Check press and social media for details. The presence of oxygen is absolutely the absence of disease. Most chronic diseases that plagues us are not happening to us, but is happening within us. We're literally eating ourselves to death, which means we're not living longer, we're dying longer. Join fitness expert Aloy Johnson, the founder of The Healthiest Corner on Earth, located at number 92 Eastern Drive, Champlain, telephone number 736-3962, every Wednesday from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. live on the Street 909 FM, where he shows you that healing the body's temple is easier than anyone would have led you to believe. So, guys, we go right back to the lines. Caller, good morning.
Hi, morning, Bruce.
Hey, Jenny, morning.
Morning, Mr. Alexia. Morning to all the callers, myself and I, 1.9. Everybody. I was listening to something that Philip Alexander said. I also listened to the Prime Minister last night in the conversation with the people at Extras. Yeah, but I'll come to that just now. Philip Alexander was being interviewed by Paul Richards on 102. And the area of something that he said caught my attention, because these are the people who want to put themselves up for governance in this country, whether as a member of parliament or the prime minister of the country. And he is saying his objective is for a better TNT. I'm paraphrasing what he's saying. His objective is for a better Trinidad and Tobago. And sometimes you have to do what it takes to get what you want, basically. And he said he understood when deceased Mr. Pandey said, if you had to sleep with the devil, that is what he would do. And he understood that. So Senator Paul Richards asked him, are you willing to sleep with the devil? And Philip Alexander responded and said, at times he has been a whore, W-H-O-R-E, to get basically what he wants. And sometimes he had to go to hell to get to heaven, basically saying that. And I listened to those words, eh? A whore. When you call somebody a whore, they don't really say prostitutes in the Caribbean, so we must say it's a whore. And we don't even say whore. We don't even pronounce it, we don't say whore. That is not something you would ascribe to, or something that you will say that you have been as a man. Women who may have had some disadvantages in their life and may have walked apart because of whatever reason, that is not something they want to be attached to them. But Philip Alexander is comfortable telling the public, telling the World Wide Web, because this is an internet radio station now, that he has been a whore sometimes, and Senator Richards is laughing uncontrollably because that is so funny. Senator Paul Richards, that a man who was just recently fighting the local government election with his party, the PET, and was in talks with Cameron Purcell, the setter for the elections of 2025. He is saying he understands when Pandey said he willing to sleep with the devil to get what he wants, and he himself has been a whore at times, and he had to go to hell sometimes to get him. You know, while he's doing that, on the other side of it, Dr. Keith Christopher Rowley is meeting with the people of this country. We are showing the population who are under that type of stress because of crime and other things happening. He's there last night, we are showing them. He's speaking to the young people. We are showing them they have a future in this country. A young guy was speaking about they have a master's and can't get work. And sometimes the OJT is not in the field that they're ready trained for. And Dr. Rollins, we are showing him, sometimes you have to take a job. A job, he's saying, eh? Yes, you have to sleep with no devil and you have to be no whore. Eh? Take the job in the OJT program. It may not be exactly the master's that you would have studied for, but it gives you an opportunity in those 2 years to get some experience. And even while you're doing the OJT, you may even change from that field that it wasn't before and end up doing that. That's what he's telling the young people. Another young person said the field she studied is not one that is known, is popular in Trinidad. She has to go abroad, it's extensive. One of the government can assist her. And Dr. Rini explaining to her that there are programs like that. However, it is difficult sometimes to fund those programs, but he's still given her hope. And he said, if I was the government was supposed to select a few who in your field, send them abroad to study, you know what people are going to say? Discrimination. And those are the things she was talking to the young people, giving her hope. Another one came up and said, I am a national, I was a former swimmer. I am training these young people in my community, Rio Claro, to swim. And you're building a pool in Bish. How are we going to get to Bish? And he said, you know, I spoke to somebody from the family person. And he said, so why am I going to keep saying Bish? He said, you are the person with the children who they allow them to swim in somebody's pool in the backyard. You have this beautiful program. She said, yes, it's me. And Dr. Rowley, I saw the pool will be coming to Rio Claro. We have to continue our good work. That is what Dr. Rowley is saying to the young people, again, I hope. When Philip Alexander is saying, he understands he could sleep with the devil to get away on, and he could be a whore. And a man from Telepona came and spoke about a beautiful program that they have with the business owners in Telepona, a security program at that level, where they're putting cameras, not on the streets and the posts that the government is doing, but in the different areas, and there's a command center and the police station in Telepona that is watching everything happening at that level. And he wants to partner with the government, national security, to carry on that, because the other areas, Shogunas and the other business owners, call them for that type of program. And Dr. Rowley is saying, we have to meet with you. Because while we're doing the national security, we're putting on the highways and byways, this is something at a level where it's more down to the ground. So we'll partner with you because it sounds good. Because the business people are paying money so they can fix and maintain these cameras. That is what Dr. Rowley is doing. Giving hope to this country and Philip Alexander at the end now is telling me he has been a whore, WHORE, at times, and laughing and giggling with it, with Senator Paul Richards, and he understands, speaking with the devil to get whatever you want. Is that the hope they want to bring to this country, Bruce Wayne and others who listen? But you want the hope that Dr. Rowley sat down and spoke to this nation as a father who cares about what happened to the youths and the people of this country? Isn't that what you want as a leadership? Isn't that what you want in the office as the prime minister? Isn't that what you want for this country? That a man saying that he has been a whore? And the next one, all kind of talk, they talk about drunk, fall down, all kind of thing. That's what we want in this country. People wake up, you know, shake up, you know. Listen, understand, and don't use your emotional intelligence to make a decision. Don't go off and I don't like this and I don't like. Listen to what they are saying and who bringing hope to this country. Bruce, as usual, thank you for the opportunity. Everybody have a blessed day.
Thank you. Caller, good morning.
Hello, morning.
Morning, morning.
Morning, Bruce. How are you?
Hi there, Cole Brian. What's going on?
Not too bad at all, my good friend. Good to see you.
Yeah, man.
As always. And I have to concur with your callers before 7 that you are sacred to your duty to come out there to give us that level of support, those of us who look on, those of us who listen, those of us who call in. And I, too, would like to expressly thank you for that, Bruce. I know it's not easy to get a lot of early morning. You're up before the sun comes up, and I know certainly you don't go to sleep before the sun goes down, and that effort has to be commended. I want to thank you very much for that. Good morning, Miss Felix. I know you're under the weather a bit. All strength within for you, and hope to see you soon. Good morning to your listeners and callers. Bruce, before I get into what I really want to talk about, last night, today, the Honorable Prime Minister is to meet with the relatives of the 4 divers who lost their lives at the Paria issue. I would like the Honorable Prime Minister, now, I know the Honorable Prime Minister will go with an open mind to listen to the wives and the families and so on. But I would also like him to be very, very careful, because one of those persons is now a UNC counselor. And while he goes with an open mind, please go with other people, Dr. Rowley. Don't just go by yourself, because these things have been so politicized that he has to be very, very careful. While he may be going there to seriously listen and to share his concerns and so on with the bereaved and so on, he has to understand this has been totally politicized, and therefore I would urge him to perhaps let other ministers accompany him who will be able to understand what he's attempting to deliver and what he's attempting to discuss with the families of the fallen divers in the Paria that point appeared 2 years ago. That's all I'm saying. Please. Yes? Now, Dominic, a lot of things transpired last night, and I have to agree with Sister Jenny with respect to 2 things that stood out for me, and one was, I think the gentleman, his name is Mr. Budu, who says that with the camera issue in Tunapuna and so on, and Dr. Rowley indicated that he needs to partner with him and get on board with him. And I'd like to urge the Honorable Prime Minister to do that sooner rather than later. Because from what I heard, and I've heard about it before. Yes, I heard about the I didn't know it was this gentleman, but I heard about what was happening in Tunapuna before with the cameras and CCTV cameras. And I think if Dr. Rowley is really and truly interested in partnering with him, he should do that sooner rather than later. Because I think the initiative is very good for the country. And if you have somebody who is willing to work with the government in a positive manner to alleviate some of the issues and some of the things that are happening in the country vis-a-vis crime, yes, I think that initiative should be taken on board rather quickly. And secondly, Bruce, with respect to the lady from Rio Claro, who is doing her utmost best to assist the youths of the area, in her area with swimming and so on, I think that pool, I'm happy that she came from Rio Claro, Bruce, way up the Exodus Spaniard, Bruce. Look at how far she came to ensure that she got the eye and the ear of the Honorable Prime Minister, and that, for that, she should be commended. Yes, because she could have said, I'm going to wait till he comes down south. No, I am going to meet you on your ground and speak with you to ensure that my message is clear and concise. And I am happy that she did, and she cleared up that thinking, that thought that the Honorable Prime Minister would have initially had. So now he knows where he has to put the pool. And this is important for the youths of that particular area, a rural area that would be injected with that type of activity. And I'm certain it's going to grow, Bruce. And this is what is important. And what the Honorable Prime Minister started in Lavantil. You see how many people want it now, Bruce? While it was bad talking, did you see what's going on?
Yeah.
And it just goes to show, while some people playing politics with things, good initiatives that this government has put on the table for the citizens and the youth and the children of Trinidad and Tobago, we have people coming from quite Rio Claro to say, hey, it's not Beach, it's Rio, and it's a far distance, so please ensure that pool goes in the current. And I must congratulate Dr. Rowley, because he didn't pass it off, he didn't forget, because he was able to recall it immediately. Yes, and that was very, very important. That piece of discussion with that lady was extremely important. I must congratulate her. But Bruce, they know there are good sides and bad sides. This morning, I have to listen on a particular television station with a certain fella who at one time said he was going to challenge Dr. Rowley in Digo Martin West. And when he must have realized, now, nah, I can't beat this man down there. Let me go in an easier place. So he goes to St. Joseph. And he started to talk about Dr. Rowley as a liar. What he said last night, he's a liar. He's a this and he's a that. You know, man, Dr. Rowley really renting space, and that fella is. So JW decided to give him his opportunity to vent this morning. You understand? Give him opportunity to vent. And what do you think he's going to come on and say Dr. Rowley was talking the truth? Dr. Rowley is a liar. And Dr. Rowley is the worst. And Dr. Rowley... Dr. Rowley rented space in between them fellas two ears, because they have nothing else on the table. And you coming to say what you're going to do for the people at St. Joseph, because you still live there? Well, last year went St. Joseph. But you see, the whole point of the matter is politics. I wonder what Anil Roberts, who has been walking that particular area, have to say this morning. It'll be nice to hear, because apparently this gentleman has been given a sense of congratulations from certain members of the UNC. And when the honorable opposition leader is telling members of her party that what you want to do with respect to what is it she said, that your ambitions outweigh your ability, and get in line, otherwise I will put you out. Is that not a dictatorship? But nobody is saying that today.
Oh.
You can imagine Dr. Rowley saying that to one of his members, that, hey, get in line, I'll put you out. What do you think would be happening this morning in the headlines? The dictator speaks. But with that side, is there no dictator? No. Line a dictator. Get in line, Pare, otherwise you're out. People must listen to these things and draw their own conclusions. Bruce, have a good day.
You too, man. Take care. Get in line or get out, eh? Straightforward, to the point. Caller, good morning.
Hello, good morning, Bruce.
Morning, morning, Mr. Chance. How are you doing?
How are you doing? Where's my daughter this morning?
She's I
still problem?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, my daughter, wherever you are, yes, hold on to that throat, all the titans. Very special good morning to all of you in Tobago and in Trinidad and, you know, on the international titans. I do want to follow up on Chen Chen. Bruce, on Monday, in my discourse, I was talking to the listeners in terms of it requires money to run this country. And I want to see that again today. Because after listening to the Prime Minister and the Minister of Finance, I was there at the Express Bank Theatre last night in person. And I mean, it was amazing. And I hope that all our people of Trinidad and Tobago got a window of opportunity to hear that this country is not run by VAPs. This country is not run by wishes. This country is not run by a tree that is bearing money in the Philippines. This country is not run by digging a hole and having money there, and every morning you pick out money. You have to get the money. You have to get those resources. And last night it was very clear. The Minister of Finance was there a little late. And you know what he told the Prime Minister? He was doing a very important business. Is making sure that public servants get paid after signing those documents to make sure they get paid. You know how much it costs, Bruce, 1 month to pay the salaries and wages of all the workers in Trinidad and Tobago, public sector workers? $1.4 billion a month, Bruce. You hear that?
Wow.
Bruce, that, they're not picking up enough tree, you know. There's no tomato tree or no bygone tree. On Pak Choi, that behind money, Bruce. He has to find, and he told us, $1.4 billion a month to pay. And I want to add to that, that when we hear free education, that is just a word in brackets, you know, because it costs this country $8 billion in the budget allocation this year for that free education, you know, $8 billion a year. When we hear free health care, it's not free, Bruce. We pay a little change in health surcharge, but you know what it's costing the country for that free health care, Bruce? $7 billion a year, Bruce. For granny to get her pension, and our people to get the disability grant, and our public assistance, and all the support that they have in social welfare. It is $5.5 billion a year, Bruce. Bruce, where that money is coming from, Bruce? Bruce, in every country, it says what your country, not only what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. We all have to play a part in providing the resources, whether they are human resources and financial resources, for the growth and development of our country. It happens all over the world. So this nonsense that this UNC is promoting, that no, don't contribute, don't pay tax. And I want to make that point again. What is the reason behind all of that? I'm going to repeat it. There are people in this country, Bruce, who got their land and property by illegal means, through bobol, through corruption, through thiefing, through fraud, Bruce. And you know how they dispose of that money? They buy property and land, Bruce. That's how they buy it. They get it. It is called money laundering. They take it from negative use and they put it on a positive. So they have land and property all over the place. But you know, Bruce, with this property tax, you'll have to declare all of that. And you know the question will come up, Bruce? Where you get all of that money from? Explain your wealth, Bruce. Do not allow those people who have things to hide to con our people into not paying their property tax. Please, I'm begging all our people. Last night, the Minister of Finance gave me a figure there, which I myself have to repeat to you. 250,000 of us paying approximately $3 a day in property tax. You hear, Bruce? That is just just over a quarter of the population. 250,000 of us. You know what we're paying, Bruce? We're paying the cost of a bottle of water. That's a bottle of water, Bruce. A day to ensure that your property is there for the generation to come. You can pass it on from one generation to the next. Your land and property, Bruce, does not depreciate. It appreciates. In other words, the price of it increases every day. So your great grandchildren and so on, the property you leave for them will be significantly increased over the years. And you are paying the cost of a bottled water. Just appreciate $3 a day. Multiply by the number of the 365 days. That is what you're paying. The cost of a bottled water, Bruce. And these children want to con all of us. 250,000 of us paying that. And they, with a big property, hidden away. But this property tax will find it. Suppose I saw this morning, I will mention that because we need to get rid of this boogie that we must not pay property tax. And yeah. Bruce, in not paying that property tax over all those years, you know, Bruce, we lost close to $3 billion, Bruce. Over all those 13 years, Bruce, you know what $3 billion would have done for us, Bruce? For the young people to create opportunity, to help us pay all those bills we're talking about. The bill for the health, the bill for the education, the bill for social welfare. All that money will help us, Bruce. And that is why we have to contribute to the development of our country. Those of us who can and those of us who can't, we will help them. That is what a country is all about. That is what civility is all about. That is what the development of a nation is all about. Coming together to do it. So I want to congratulate the government. And I want to encourage all of us, to make that contribution. Particularly most of us. Because there are 400,000 people with residential properties in this country. And 250,000 of us won't be paying the cost of a bottle of water at Eagles. Bruce, let me encourage our people again. Do not be conned. Go out and pay your property tax and contribute to the development of your people and your country. Thank you very much for the time, Bruce.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chance. Caller, good morning.
See them rich people? Them in this country.
Caller, good morning.
Yes, Uncle Brucey. Yes, Professor Chan, thank you very much for on the ground explanation after the finance minister and Dr. Rowley. I said the same thing to the people this morning. You all go and pay your property tax. Some bottle water is $5, so you're even paying more for a bottle water than what you're going to be paying for your property. Pay for what you have. When you have your property, you are a part of your country. Do what you have to do, people, and stop listening to these people who have so much. Sister Jenny, I love you with your contribution this morning. This is the behavior of these kind of people, and they are the ones that want to come and lead us and talk rubbish about Dr. Rowley. Dr. Rowley doesn't bring himself to those low-class, foolish behavior. Dr. Rowley is a real song performing leader. That is why everything it has in the Caribbean, more or less, Dr. Rowley is invited, and he does be one of the feature speakers. I don't know why Trinidad people and Tobago people at Trinidad and Tobago, they're not seeing this. Why they're not seeing this, that we try to have a country? I have 13 grandchildren, one great-grandchild for now, and I know I'll get 20 more because I have 20 boys and girls in the family. Their future. I am an aged man already. A couple of weeks from now, I'm going to be 73 years. I am fighting with Dr. Rowley and they for the future of Trinidad and Tobago, which is going to be beneficial to my children, and my great-grandchildren. That is what I am fighting for. Because of my father did what he had to do as a young man, that is why I'm an inheritor to property in Tobago. And I'm happy and glad about it. So come on. And mommy, let me say something. Why 64,000 firearms came into the country? You know, it's because it was a soul man. A soul man was the commissioner of police at that time. You know that Calypso by the Mighty Funny? All right. A soul man. So this is all the stupidness that is taking place here. That is why we have injunction. And the Prime Minister can't read what he has to read in the Parliament. But don't worry. Time will tell. Time will tell about that. Yeah. Come on, Mr. Malcolm and Gemma. Happy anniversary to you all. God bless you all. 53 years is a long, long time. That is more than half of my age. All right? So love you all of you. And there you go, Uncle Brucey. Have a good one when you leave, man.
Yeah. Blessings. Caller, good morning.
Hey, Bruce, good morning.
Morning.
Sharo, morning. Titan, the democracy, morning, everybody. Bruce, I saw now that the family now put in a request to speak to the Prime Minister, meet with the Prime Minister, and the Prime Minister accepted. Because they now get some sense. Remember, when the tragedy happened, the Prime Minister came out and he spoke. The Prime Minister was saying that he's going to have a proof. And the Prime Minister had already contacted and have people already, some professionals from the United States and the and local ones in, have approved in the, this, they bought pieces, Joe jumping from the UNC. No probe, no probe. The government want to hide it and cover it up. So they wanted a commissioner inquiry. Dr. Roy, listen, the banting all over the place, people talking loud. We call us a commissioner inquiry. When the commissioner inquiry come on, Praka jumped in the fray and all that. They didn't want any commissioner. He wanted the government to just come and just hand money out of the treasury just like that and give it to the family.
Hmm.
So he stood firm because Paria has this law firm whose legal advice was advising them. And when the law firm advised the board of Paria, they report to the minister and the minister reports to the Prime Minister. But Dr. Roll as the Prime Minister to just jump $1 million to this one and that family and for votes and everything. Oh, look how nice. What a nice man. But I put the country in more problems, you know. Because Dr. Roll, what he have been doing if he did that was accept liability for a company, LMSC, who broke a lot of health and safety rules. And some of the things when we come out of that and stop me, hey, some of them for them, it's just they're not even commercial drivers. They drive for like fun and things. They're not, some of them not even properly certified to do that kind of diving. Equipment was poor. It's all kind of thing that do even down to the insurance. What we hear come out of that they have the insurance, but what the insurance expired and they didn't pay it, and they went and run a bit afterwards. Because, Bruce, let me tell you something. Those places, when you go in the oil field and do the work, that's why they pay a lot of money, because it's a high risk. You're high risk. Anything can happen. So the family and them had to understand that if something like that happens, you have to accept it. I mean, yes, it will be hard for you. You have to weep. You have to cry. Everything, but however, insurance will kick in from the company. The company will ensure that you get that, your family gets X amount of money from your thing and that. Right? Second part now, Paria will look at the situation, and what Paria will do is Paria will know, say, okay, so, and give them a little package of the family, will get another package from thing. All depends on the advice of their law firm. And after they get that advice from the law firm, they take it to the minister. The minister and the cabinet will sit down and go through it with the AG to ensure that all T's are crossed and all I's are dot. That is how it's supposed to happen. But Prakash wanted to jumpstart his political career. Carry the family and then for a whole spin all around the place. And now they had to come right back down and do the thing they're supposed to do. Because Prakash was saying how much million to give them. Give them million. The government has had to give them million. And when he say he'll take them to court and thing, and then he jump back and say, yeah, that will take too long and thing, and the thing will come and the family. Prakash didn't know that. And Prakash is our senior counsel. Mr. Charles, Prakash is our senior counsel. I just want to just verify that. But if he carrying that status, or he's a bottom high-level lawyer, why you misled the people? Prakash Ramadan would have misled the people and had them spinning a top all along the road, because basically Prakash was fighting the matter for them and never even discussed the responsibilities of LMCS. And he is their lawyer. And there lies my problem, because I am saying, and I'm telling Dr. Rowley, that is my taxpayers' money. And I want to make sure that when I reach retirement age and those things, I want the thing for my country, because I have served my country well. I pay a lot of taxes in this country, and I deserve to have some sort of benefits and my old age for my country. And you have to guide and hold the Treasury's money and make sure that money is not being spent wild and end up in all these other people from the UNC hands. And next thing you know, when I reach old age, I have no pension to get because IMF take over. No. That is very problem lies, you know. Thank you.
Caller, good morning.
Bruce.
Mm-hmm.
I hear Brian calling you, Dominic. You change your name. And let me say good morning to the lady who said good morning to me. Not to the lady who want to go lick it for me. I will leave it here.
Caller, good morning.
Morning,
Bruce.
Morning. Morning, Deshaun. Everybody. Deal, everybody. Bruce, I too was in Ifeanyi last time. And if you don't understand what Ifeanyi is going to say, you either have a problem with English or you have a problem with understanding. Because it is the simplest thing. And if you don't understand that, and if you want to listen to the people who want to call, who don't know what they're talking about, first meeting, I want to call and spread lies, you could go ahead and listen to them. But I too was in the panel last night, and I sat down and I listened. From the actual man who knows everything what's going on, and he became them, he's typically the simplest thing. And if you can't understand that, then you have an issue with English, or you really can't, or you have a problem with comprehension. And this dude acts like a real brat. What I hear Dr. Oyla said, mention my name, I say, oh God. Because I was expecting to see this morning, like clockwork. And all of a sudden, you're going to do this. Why are you staying in the Martin last week? You was with my here? Edwards?
You know, come along there.
We was waiting on him. Why are you staying in the Martin last week? We sit and wait on him. They're coming to come down in COVID room. You cannot come here with money. You go and do it. Because you feel the battle across is easier. Mm-hmm. Little do you know. Little do you know. and like I said, Bruce, and you have people who just sit on here and just talking, and they wouldn't listen. Seriously? Anyhow, walk down, listen, I'll go on. And Bruce, before I go, Bruce. Hello?
Yeah, man.
Try and get him. Them two white phone number. God, boy. I don't know what Dr. Lee does, man. I don't know. Like Dr. Lee, take some girl from this man, because I understand he have no trade. So I can't do that. Dr. Lee, but take some girl from me. And he had a grudge forever and ever. Amen? Lord, try and get him to get them two phone number. Lord,
I feel so.
I'm going.
Caller, good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
You know, I watched a program last night with the Prime Minister on the television. And you know what surprised me? It isn't surprising, because not since Dr. Eric Williams, we have seen a Prime Minister who is speaking to the public. And he does not have a set of ministers with him there. That when something comes up that another minister supposed to be referred to answer that question. This Prime Minister, everything is, he don't even read from a piece of paper. His retainance is so good And I noticed this over the years. Dr. Rowley don't read. Everything is inside his head. It shows the caring and the passion of a person who really loves Trinidad and Tobago. It shows an individual who people misconstrued his passion and call it arrogance. Look at what happened with him and Mr. Imbert yesterday. Now he was anxious. Yes, you cannot see it in his demeanor while he was sitting there. That he was concerned about Mr. Imbert coming to let the public know exactly what he wanted Mr. Imbert to tell us. And that is how Dr. Rowley is. He's a little anxious with Twitter. And then when Colin Imbert came in and he told him, I hope you have an apology about that. A friend of mine who is on the other side of the political fence called and telling me, look at that arrogance. He's telling Imbert that he has to apologize. Right? And I don't understand why these people see things in a totally different light to what it is. Mr. Imbert wasn't embarrassed and went up on the podium his face was drawn down as a result of that little friendly banter that goes on with a lot of PNM members, right? So I am concerned about a lot of the only thing I'm concerned about with the delivery of the PNM is that sometimes they don't go down to the grassroots level. Language-wise, I'm talking. Language-wise. When Dr. Rowley says $1 billion, I ask a lot of people along my area, I would ask them, you know how much is $1 billion? They don't know that $1 billion is $1,000 million. That's $1,000 million, right? And they feel it's a couple millions. So they need to get down and tell them exactly, boy, it's $1,000 million or it's $5,000 million or whatever the situation is. Because a lot of the population is unaware of the finances. They don't even, they can't even conceive what $1 billion is or millions of dollars. Thanks for the time this morning.
Amen. Thank you. Yeah. Caller, good morning.
Good morning to you, Boosty Boswin.
Hey, morning, my brother. How are you doing?
Morning. Yeah, you're right. Mr. Sharon Felix, all loyal listeners and callers and all who are in life. Well, I also had to talk about the property tax, you know. Yeah, it's just a bottle of water, but listen to me carefully, Bruce. Some of them have cars. They have to fill up the cars monthly. And I show it's hundreds. They pay hundreds of dollars. They have telephone. And just to talk, they have special promotion or some plan to talk on the phone over $300. And you understand what I'm saying? And $3 is a problem for people to pay for where you put in your head, where your rest is, where you will live 24 hours a day. $3. And watch my booze. It will have people who will be paying less than $3. Understand what I'm saying? That property might be up somewhere close to $1 million while you're paying $3. But that property under that $500,000 mark that will be paying less than $3. Understand what I'm saying, Bruce?
Yeah.
And the people and them who in Rio Claro calling for pool, it have somebody saying that how the pool in Sobretry is not functional. And Bruce, April coming is April Pool's Day. You understand what I'm saying, yeah? April Pool's Day in Sogretry Swimming Pool. Understand what I'm saying? So they start since Monday they start, because I think school finished Friday, and since Monday they start coming. Yeah, they have the classes accordingly. Understand what I'm saying, Bruce?
Yeah.
And it is a plus for all these communities. The people and them who have children who just want to be home or anything, join the classes and send them to swim. We could get another Carter or some one of these, this guy, what's his name, black man, you understand, who is making waves in the pool. So I thank the government for that. And one more thing, Bruce. Please, people, a bachak does come and clean down your own tree, and every one of them walk with a piece of thing and go inside the nest and chew it. That is what property talks come like. All are we putting our resources into the regional corporation. That is why the residential tax comes first, Bruce. The commercial, the industrial, and the agricultural, that will go into the consolidated fund so that the government will be spending the money wisely. People, don't be fooled. It are people who have properties and they don't know how to have paperwork for it. This is what's going on. And if the government want to introduce I 110%, go ahead, Dr. Rowley, go ahead, Minister of Finance, and introduce the property tax. Thank you very much, Bruce.
Thank you. Caller, good morning.
Hey, good morning, Bruce.
Good morning.
I wouldn't be long.
Mm-hmm.
If this country have to move forward, the only how this country can move forward is if they get rid of Kamala Pusabi Sasa. These USA people have to get rid of her and put somebody with a level head. Then, you know, that we onto something. Once Kamala is there, we will always have problems. The problem is not the prime minister. No. The problem is the opposition leader. That is all I have to say. Because if we keep that woman there, she will always have a problem with anybody who is against her. No, nothing is wrong with the opposition at all. Because the opposition has kept our government intact. But the problem is, these people are so set in the ways that anything that is good for the country, they will always be against it. And for years, them like that. And Kamala is a person done set in her ways. So you are seeing somebody younger, somebody who is not culture thinking to move forward in this country. Once she is there, we will never move forward in anything. Have a good morning.
Amen. Blessings. So guys, that's all the time we have for today. It was a pleasure being in your company. It was a pleasure having you in mind. Up next, we have Mr. Aloy Johnson with the healthiest corner on earth. So keep it locked to the Street 919 FM. Talk to you guys tomorrow, please God. Ciao, ciao.